Now, it's the final days of the Royal Easter Show, but there's still plenty to see and do, and David Robertson is there for us this morning. Now, Robbo, have you recovered from a little earlier when you rode the Avenger while eating a meat pie and a lasagna on a stick?
Well, Sarah Harris, when you ride the Avenger and you eat a lasagna and a meat pie, it kind of scars you for a long time. As you can hear there, I try and put it across an image that I'm masculine, but clearly I'm not. No one's surprised there.
Did you feel sick?
The screaming does all the talking, doesn't it? Oh my goodness. Is that really me? I don't think that's not me, is it?
I don't want to do this anymore.
I'm surprised you didn't toss your cookies, Rob. Robbo.
That's right. Like, I'm calling out for God, and that's the right time of year, I think. He didn't help me, though.
Yeah, usually food's going out, not going in on those sorts of rides. Now, Robbo, I believe there is more food involved in your next challenge.
That's right, Sarah Harris. Look, when you've gone on a crazy ride at the Royal Easter Show, the best way to calm down and relax is to come to the Country Women's Association stand, or the CWA Tea Room. And I'm joined now by my beautiful friend, Carol. Carol, good morning to you.
Good morning.
Now, you are the chairwoman, chairwoman?
That's right.
The chairwoman. We're all about being equal here, aren't we? The chairwoman of the CWA. Do you mind if I put my arm around you? It's nothing weird.
You can give me a cuddle.
I can give you a cuddle.
Hello.
All right, Carol, let's have a scone first and a drink, and we'll talk about it later. But first, Carol, if we can talk about your scones. Now, it's a big part of the show, isn't it? Now, you serve almost how many per day?
Around about 4,000 a day.
4,000 scones per day.
Yes, it's a lot of scones.
That's a lot of scones. Now, the record was almost 50,000 in 2015, and you're hoping to break that now. Is that right?
Right. It was 49,100, and this year we hope to go over the 50,000, and we're already up to 42,000, so it looks like we might break the record this year.
The whole country is behind you, the women and the men, might I say, Carol. So you've got to beat 49,000, and you've got 3 days to do it.
That's right. So it looks like we might do that.
Now, I know that they taste delicious. The country knows they taste delicious. We've got to check. We've got a very special guest here this morning, and that is, of course, my very good friend, Julie Goodwin, the first MasterChef Australia. Julie Goodwin, good morning to you.
Good morning. Thank you for having me.
Oh, we are so excited that you're here on Studio 10. Thank you so much for joining us. Now, would you mind, we're going to get you to taste test this scone this morning. Is that okay?
I would love to. Thank you.
All right. Let me just serve this up now. We've got some whipped cream here. Dop that on there. It's all about the love. Is that right? You're going to respect the scone?
Yeah, you have.
Am I respecting the scone so far?
Oh, you're doing brilliantly.
Oh, thank you. So you got to respect the scone, Sarah. And I'm respecting that. Oh, excuse fingers. Hold on. Oh, thank you so much, Carol. It's all about hygiene. Oh, my God. Okay. Excuse fingers here. We're all friends. Let me put that there. Julie, wrap your gums around that. Let me know what it means.
Oh,
well. Oh. Now, the suspense is killing me. Carol, so far, we've got the one MasterChef of Australia here, Julie Goodwin, just swallowing, just savouring that taste. Are you nervous? Yeah. Are you confident?
I'm confident.
Confident?
I'm a bit nervous.
Bit nervous. Yeah. Carol, let's see what she says. We cross now live to Julie Goodwin at the CWA tea room. Julie Goodwin, what can you tell us about Carol's scones?
Absolutely beautiful.
There we go. Absolutely beautiful. No worries about that, Carol. How do you feel?
Very relieved.
We're very revealed. Julie Goodwin, is that the scone that you've always wanted to taste?
Oh, absolutely, yep. Robbo. Absolutely. 100%. Yep. You need to get down here. We want to help them break that record of 50,000 this year. Yeah.
That is exactly right. We want to help them break the record. Now, also, MasterChef coming back to the best network in Australia. Not a lot of people know that, but it really is the best network, Network 10. Now, MasterChef is coming back. You're excited about that?
I really am. I've watched every series. Yep. It's a program that changed my life, obviously, in a huge way. Yep. And I cannot wait. The ads, the food on the ads looks amazing. So I can't wait to see.
It'll be amazing. Now, also, Julie Goodwin, for the budding MasterChefs who haven't made it to the show, you've got a new cookbook out. What can you tell us?
It's called Essential Cookbook, and it's all the building blocks of cooking that you need and a whole lot of yummy stuff that my family and friends really love.
Scones?
Oh, Julie Goodwin, I can't wait to cook from it. It's scones in there, scones?
Oh, there will be. There's everything in there, everything.
That's right. For more information, you want to head to juliegoodwin.com.au. Now, for the CWA, you want to head to CWA of New South Wales, nsw.org.au. Trust me on this, Sarah Harris and everyone there in the studio and everyone around Australia. You want to taste these scones. They are absolutely delicious. Eastershow.com.au for more information. Carol, thank you so much. Cheers to you.
Robbo, we are watching you with our mouths watering. You've left out a couple of very important points about the scones. Can you please ask Carol, are they buttermilk scones? And what is the secret ingredient that makes her scones better than everyone else's?
Well, no, Carol, that's not it. Apparently, we've got some questions here from the panel. They're a little bit sceptical about the CWA. I'm going to have a word to them later. But if you could tell me, they're asking, are these buttermilk scones?
It's one of our secret recipes.
Secret recipe, Sarah Harris. We can't tell you.
No, we can't. No, it's not the one on the tea towel. No, it's a special recipe that we have just for the show, and we can't tell
you. Secret recipes there, Sarah Harris. We can't tell you what they are. What I can tell you, though, is Angela Goodwin will say this is the right. They are absolutely delicious.
Oh,
is that right?
They are.
Really good, yep.
Light, fluffy, everything you want. Beautiful.